To migrate our PyProcessBook displays, we will want to first open the PyProcessBook to PyVision display utility using the shortcut on the desktop. To start in the utility, we want to select the files and folders we want to analyze. I'll click Add Files and select Folders. And I'll go ahead and select the ProcessBook folder. So here we can see it's imported all of the PDI files and folders that exist to the list. I'll click Select All at the bottom left to select all of the files to analyze, and then select Run Analysis. After that has completed, we get an analysis completed message, and the analysis results are shown in the right pane. The default view is called Summary View, and it categorizes the displays to what can be fully migrated, partially migrated, or cannot be migrated, if, for example, the file was corrupt. Here we can expand each of these categories to see which displays can be fully or partially migrated. We can also switch to Tree View to show the displays in their original hierarchy. Those are the two ways we can organize the results of the analysis. I'll switch back to Summary View, and if we hover over the eye icon next to each of the categories, we can see the full definition of these categories. Most of our displays can be fully migrated, but there are some displays that can be partially migrated. In the Issues column, there are that tell us what specifically could not be migrated. In the PG Flynn plant file, there are some datasets that will not be migrated. And in the Pi Data Archive monitoring display, there are different time ranges and VBA code, which is not supported in PyVision. Since we do have VBA in one display, we want to export that code to preserve that information. So we are going to do that by checking that display and selecting Export VBA. After that completes, we will go to the View Reports dropdown and select Open Reports folder. Here we have the migration analysis file along with the VBA file. We will open the VBA file in Notepad, and we can see all of the code that we saw in the PyProcessBook file in the last exercise. If we need to, we can take this file back to our IT department so they have that information. Next, we will open up the migrationanalysis.csv file and take a look. Here we can see more detailed information about all of the symbols in the displays and whether they are okay to be migrated or if there are some discrepancies, such as font or formatting settings that are not supported in PyVision. In the last part of the exercise, we are going to go ahead and migrate all of our PyProcessBook files into PyVision. So we will make sure we have all of our files selected in the Analysis Results pane. One note to mention here is that because all of our Flynn displays have links between them, we want to make sure we migrate all of them in the same operation so that those links are preserved. We will go ahead and click on Migrate Displays, and this will open up the Migration Settings window. First, we will put in our PyVision URL, which for us is just https://pyvision/pyvision, and then click Connect. Once we've connected to our PyVision server, we can fill out the rest of our migration configuration settings. The destination PyVision folder is the PyVision folder where the migrated displays will be located. Since we are going to persist the folder structure, the folder we want is not available in PyVision yet, so we will leave that as home. The target display owner will be the AD user who will be the owner of the migrated displays. The default is the user running the utility, and other owner options include users who have previously created a display in PyVision or have been granted access to PyVision. We will select our Student 01 user for this option. Display Sharing Access is the AF identities who will have access to the migrated PyVision displays. We will keep the default of World. We also want to check Persist Folder Structure from Migrated Items. This will keep the same folder structure as shown in the analysis results, and folders will be created if needed. The duplicate file names for us does not matter as this is our first migration of these displays, but if we had to remigrate some displays, we have the option to either skip or overwrite duplicate file names. Now we can go ahead with the migration by clicking OK. Once we get the migration completed message, we can go to View Reports, Migration Report, to see the list of displays, their URLs, and their migration status. That completes the second exercise on working with the migration utility.